morning, dear students. Today we will study our next poem from the Hive textbook, and the title is A Slumber Did My Spirit Steal, written by William Wordsworth. This poem is written by William Wordsworth in 1798, and this is one of the Lucy poems. Lucy poems means the poems which William Wordsworth had written in the memory of his beloved. So that all the poems he had given name Lucy poem. So this is one of from that of his Lucy poems. This poem is dedicated to his beloved soul, because now her his beloved was not alive. So in her memories he had written this poem. So now I am starting. Slumber means what? Sleep.
Deep sleep.
Deep sleep. And spirit means soul. Spirit means what?
Determination.
Soul.
Sleep.
Deep sleep. Deep sleep. Deep sleep. Deep sleep. Deep sleep. Deep sleep. Deep sleep. Deep sleep. Deep sleep. Deep sleep. Deep
sleep. Deep sleep. Deep sleep. Deep sleep. Deep sleep. Deep sleep. Deep
sleep. Deep sleep. Deep sleep. Deep sleep. Deep sleep. Deep sleep. Deep sleep. Deep sleep. Deep sleep. Deep sleep. Deep sleep. Deep sleep. Deep sleep. Deep sleep. Deep sleep. Deep sleep. Deep sleep. Deep sleep. Deep sleep. Deep sleep. Deep sleep. Deep sleep. Deep sleep. Deep sleep. Deep sleep. Deep sleep. Deep sleep. Deep sleep. Deep sleep. Deep sleep. Deep sleep. Deep sleep. Deep sleep. Deep sleep. Deep sleep. Deep sleep. Deep sleep. Deep sleep. Deep sleep. Deep sleep. Because in earlier I told you he had written this in the memory of her, his beloved. How does he imagine her to be after death? A slumber did my spirit seal. I had no human fears. She seemed a thing that could not feel the touch of early years. No motion had she now, no force. She neither hears nor sees, rolled round in earth's diurnal course with rocks and stones and trees. So a slumber means a deep sleep. Deep sleep. It means in the starting line by we can understand that the poet's beloved, now she is not alive and the poet was missing her. And how he was missing, that we will study. A slumber did my spirit seal. It means the poet is saying that my beloved was caught by a deep sleep. I had no human fears, and now he is saying that I had not any other fears that she died. But he is thinking like that she is there only. And sometimes we think like that after anyone's death they become ghost. If we feel that, it means they became ghost. But the poet is not feeling like this, like that he doesn't feel afraid or fear. She seemed a thing that could not feel. Now that lady has become that the poet could not feel her, because she is not there. Actually she died, but then also poet wanted to feel her and it was not possible. So she seemed a thing that could not feel. It means the poet is saying that now she has become a thing which could not be felt by anyone. The touch of early years, no motion has she now. Now because she died, so she became motionless, and no force, there is not any other force in her body. She neither hears, we cannot hear or we cannot see her. We cannot see her body and we cannot hear her voice also, because she is not there, she died. Rolled round in earth's diurnal course. Rolled round, see in this alliteration is used. Ra sound is repeating. Rolled round in earth's diurnal course. It means because she buried in the earth. The poet is saying why he cannot hear the voice and he cannot see that lady, because she was buried in the earth, because she died. And after anyone's death, what we do? We buried the dead body in the earth with rocks and stones and trees. So now the poet is saying, this is his imagination. He is saying that now she became maybe trees or maybe rocks or maybe stones. It means the poet is saying, because after anyone's death, we don't know that where they live or what they become after death. But now this is the imagination. The poet is thinking that maybe I can feel her in the stones. I can feel her in the trees, because maybe after her death she became, her soul is in the trees, or her soul is in the stones or rocks. Okay, now we will see the poetic devices of this. The first is rhyme scheme. Rhyme scheme of this poem is A B A B and a C D C D. Then the second is a alliteration. Alliteration is you see
roll
in the
round.
Third line.
Rolled round.
In this third line now, the second last, rolled round.
Yes, ma'am.
Ra sound is repeating, so that is a alliteration. Then the next poetic device is enjambment.
In third line also she.
Yes, ma'am.
She and sing both are different, na? Sha and sir.
Ma'am, neither nor.
Sha or she.
Neither nor. Yeah, that is. Neither nor, na? That is the alliteration.
Neither
nor. No sound is. Sha and sir both are different.
Roll round.
That is the alliteration, na? But a roll round. And the next time is the enjambment. Enjambment means what?
No punctuation.
After one line, if there is no punctuation mark given, punctuation marks means whether comma, interrogation mark, dash, these all are interrogation mark. So if a punctuation mark not given, it means what? That the line, particular line is continuing to the next line. So if we can see in this third line, she seemed to think that could not feel. After this field, there is no punctuation mark.
Second line.
Then second last line also, then after roll, course, roll. There is no punctuation mark. So, this is an enjambment.